guest this week is an all-time friend, teammate, and overall fastest, most explosive guy out there. Pedro Salgado explains how he evolved, how he trains, and what he thinks of the future. As he grows, so does his international presence, from events to competitions. It's undeniable how this dude is going far, and so far, there's no end in sight. This is Pedro Salgado, and this is Word of Movement.
Hey Pedro, welcome to the show. I hope you'll enjoy this brief conversation. I've known you for a long time now, probably 8 years. Do you remember the first time we met? I do.
Yes, I think it was in Setúbal.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. First time I did like kind of a wall side.
A wall side, exactly.
Yeah, I remember.
Back in 2008. 2008, man, was a long time ago. And you were just starting, so let's start with that. Can you tell us a little bit about yourself? How did you start and so on? Just a little bit about yourself.
So basically, I didn't start like watching parkour videos as most of the people, because I didn't know about parkour when I was already doing kind of that thing. I started inspired by my father. He used to do cliff diving, and I was watching him at the beach, and I was like, oh, I want to do this stuff with him, because it's like my father, you know, you want to do this stuff, it's cool. And also, we used to watch Jean-Claude Van Damme and Jackie Chan movies a lot, and I was always inspired by this kind of movement. So, yeah, that was the beginning of the adventurous spirit that I got from the movies. And I just started doing flips at the beach because of my dad to the water. And later I found a guy in my hometown, Trox, Ruben Tereza. I still remember him. Right. It was a really good time because a friend of mine told me, yeah, I know a guy that you should train with him because he does the same thing you do. But he knew what was parkour and I didn't know. Then we trained together. He kind of presented me parkour. I started watching videos, and from that moment, I just train, and never stopped.
Very good. Can you tell us when did you get into Lion Team Traces at the time, and how did that come to being? Because you know, like you, Luis, and everybody came together. I think through Cunha, right?
Well, kind of, with Cunha and Sergio, for example, me and Luis and Afonso, we were a team, Urban Monkeys, and
there
we trained a lot together, and we watched also Lion Team's videos, like Sergio and Chapelas released a video together, and me and Luis, we were also doing a video kind of video together, so we were talking, because we have kind of the same vibe, the same level, and we started training in gyms, and later on, Cunha, and Sergio, they invited me and Luis to Lion Team, and later on Afonso came up as well.
I think your movement is characterized by being very strong, very fast, and very efficient. Although you do flips and all of that stuff, you tend to be a more fast and a more explosive person in terms of parkour. How do you approach your type of movement?
Well, I think I do mostly what I feel like doing. So whatever I do and whatever is my style is what I feel like inside. It's like something that I feel comfortable doing is the most. I like to do like big jumps and being fast because it gives me joy doing that. It's not because I want to be fast or something else. It just like gives me joy. This kind of movement is the movement that gives me more joy. I do flips as well because it's fun, and we always went to the beach, me and my team, and we trained a lot of flips at the beach. And of course, when you're like young, flips are cool, so we just start doing flips. And now I still enjoy doing flips, but I think the most thing that I enjoy is like just movement, like efficient movement. Being able to do whatever you want with your body is like what motivates me.
Yeah, of course, like when you're training, like, and especially in the beginning, because You were also part of the group of people that were training without guidance. You were just maybe watching videos, training with people, and that's the way that you learned. So you didn't really plan for, oh, I want to do this movement or that type of movement. You just started doing stuff, and then you realized, like, okay, this is more comfortable, or this makes me more happy, and so I'm going to do this more.
Exactly.
And also, yeah, and the place where you lived also had a big influence on you, I think, because not being a very urbanistic place, it allowed you to be a more explosive and a stronger person in terms of jumping, right?
Yeah, I think the jumping thing is quite genetic, but also Luis and all the guys like from Lisbon jump a lot because we go too much to the beach. In the summer, we spend too much time in the sand, and we cannot just stay playing on the sand and just jump all day. And that makes our legs getting stronger. And also the training, because we have so much spots, it's like sick here in Lisbon that we just don't train flips almost, because so much parkour spots, you just don't care about training flips, only sometimes at the beach.
But like when you were starting in your hometown of Amora, is it?
Yeah.
yeah, because I never know you, like Amora, Cruz de Pau, I never know.
It's Amora. Amora is my hometown.
In Amora, it's a bit different.
But in Amora, I had really good influences. Like back in the days in Parkour Portugal, the old guys, the first guys in Parkour in Portugal, one of them, André, like Modu, you know him as well. He was a really big influence in my training in the beginning, because he showed me the condition is really important. And he trained me a lot, even if I didn't want to. I was doing quadruped in stairs and in the rain and stuff like that. And after we just kind of split, he went to Coimbra, and I keep training that things by myself, even if he was not there to make me doing it. I was doing it because I wanted already, because I noticed that makes me stronger, so I just did it.
Yeah, so it's part of your foundation to have like good conditioning, so you're stronger when you're jumping on when you're doing some other techniques. Oh, what's that?
What?
Lemonade.
Just water.
All right. Going back to the conversation. Yeah, tell us a little bit about when you went to work with Parkour Portugal.
Oh yes.
How
Parkour
old were
Portugal
you?
Was a organization in Portugal that, like, one of the first organizations in Portugal, and the main goal of that organization was making parkour in Portugal bigger. And actually they did a good job, but they quit in some point because there was not enough people and the Portugal was not ready for the parkour yet. So they basically had to stop it, and we keep training, of course, but we did a lot of jobs together, and we tried to give, like, for example, there was a kind of project that they did, Spot Seekers, was basically going to every city in Portugal, not every, but yeah, they try the most cities they could, and give trainings there, just like jams, like old-style jams. Basically, we went to the city, we do a jam, and then we leave next day or something like that. And that, if that exists now, parkour will become even bigger. I think that was really smart move, but in the time, Portugal was not ready for this. And I think Parkour Portugal, José Cano, for example, was a bit ahead of what people knew about parkour, and somehow people thought was like wrong what he was doing, but actually I think was right, but not in the right timing.
Yeah, that's a big conversation, like, with the good things that they did and maybe the bad management that maybe brought Parkour Portugal to an end. But that's another conversation. We're talking about you now, and do you think working for Parkour Portugal, you know, going to many cities, doing demos, workshops, whatever, do you think that being exposed to many different places in such a short time had a strong influence in your evolution?
Yes, for sure. I think I still believe if you train always in the same spot, you will not progress as hard as you can if you just train in a different place every day. Because if you train in the same spot every time, you get used to that spot specifically, and you don't get comfortable. You get comfortable with the spot, but not comfortable with yourself in that area. But if you go to a different place, maybe, oh, it's different here, so that you're not comfortable anymore. So I think if you train in a different, most different places as possible, you get comfortable with yourself and not with the environment around you. So I think basically it's better for your training if you just go around.
All right. And associated to that subject, how do you approach your movement? Like, how do you assess and manage your risks? Do you get injured much? How do you manage fear? How do you take care of all those situations when you're pushing the limit?
Well, injuries is like, in 10 years I only cracked this finger here, you know? Like this.
Hey, come on, man. Why you do this?
I also cracked 2 metatarsals in my feet, but that's all. And this was in a pirate show, and that one was in Riga. but yeah, injuries, it's basically if you go step by step, you avoid the injuries a bit. But about the fear thing, I think it's quite personal. Everyone has a way to overcome the fear. In my case, I don't think so much about the fear. I just think, for example, a child. If a child wants to go up on the park, the top of the park, he just go. He's not thinking what can go wrong. He just focus what he has to do to get there. And that's what you have to do in the parkour. You just have to focus in the way to overcome things and how you're going to do it and the technique and all the steps and not thinking what can happen wrong. Because that's making your head busy and not focus 100% what you should have focus on. You understand?
Very good. Yep. Absolutely. So we're talking about fear, we're talking about the way you approach movement. Do you notice any difference between the way you used to train or move, like, let's say, 6 years ago to now?
Yeah.
Or is it the same but just better?
I think a while ago, like when I was 19, for example, I just spent energy in everything. Basically, I see a cat leap, even if it's not challenging, I just did it. But now I try to train a bit more wise, not like I train with a goal, but I do stuff that I think is cooler to like worth it. For example, I don't just jump all the time random because I will get my legs tired and there is a jump after that I want to do and I will not make it because I'm tired. So I try to manage a little bit more my stamina and power, but training wise still the same, like whatever is fun to do, I'm on it.
Awesome. Okay, so let's go to the point where you started competing. When was your first competition?
2011 was the World Barclay Car, no,
parkouring. Parkouring,
yeah. That one, this one I have here, the title.
There you go.
The
Fast
Break,
Parkour, yeah.
World Championship 2011.
Exactly.
And this was the first competition. And I went because Luis told me he went the last year. Luis, the guy, the black guy that is against competition, you know?
Yes.
No, he's not against. He's just think parkour is not ready as well.
Exactly.
But I went because he told me it was really fun. It's not about competing and it's just having fun with all the people. You should go next year with me, blah, blah, blah. And then I found a way. Bruno Rosa, Honor, my best friend, he just helped me with the money to go. And I went to Berlin that year with Luis. And yeah, we're in the speed contest, I just won. And I didn't make the style contest. Because I thought that was not for me at all. I still think that, but I try it a little bit more.
Yeah, but that's the thing. That's when everybody in the parkour community, you know, outside of Portugal, could actually see how powerful your moves were. And
yeah, I think.
Yeah, yeah. Go.
Visibility wise, the competition gives you a little bit of visibility.
Yeah.
And if you go in your head, you're not going to compete. You're just going for a jam, and you have to perform that second or that time as you do a show, for example, and then it's all good. If you're not going to think, oh, I'm going to be the best guy in the world, I will beat these guys here. If you think that way, it's not right, I think. That's not parkour anymore.
Exactly.
Hey guys, if you enjoyed this video, please remember to thumbs up. Also share it with as many people as possible so everybody knows what's going on. And of course, subscribe to stay tuned for another episode of Word of Movement.